Now, I think you will appreciate them giving this little hand behind. We are the assigned faculties. We are supposed to do it, to teach with you, but Devansar is a guest faculty in this lab. And I must share with you the good news that Devansar is good or bad, is leaving us after 1 month to another assignment. So that is a, whatever the few classes, lab classes we have, we will invite Devansar to quickly cover it. First of all, two or things I just, whatever is correct. One question is asked, why int main, and what are the other options? Tell me.
Void
main.
Void
main, yes. Void main, yes. Another is, please.
Only main.
That's all. I expect at least, tell me. Tell me. Yeah. One is float.
Float,
yes. Float main. Double main. Okay, you at least that interview. Scare main. Character. Okay. But why you are using, why Devansar tell you have to use int main? That I am telling you, you use it int main. Don't use void main. Why? So that is one of the reasons you can find it out. What are the good books and what are the bad books? Please listen carefully here, here this side. Every student look at me right now. This, why? You should avoid this kind of books. If it is older books, is okay. But if it is a new book, whenever you are learning a new skill, you should not learn the old habits of the C programming. But nowadays, this is the standard thing. Can you tell me why? Because the C, why the, in the last, why you go for return? What is the return? Return? Last statement of your C programming?
Certain jump statement.
Yeah?
Return is a jump statement as soon as the.
Yeah, return is jump statement. What you return?
Zero.
Why? Why zero? You should ask. Why zero?
So the return type is int main and it will.
Okay. Okay, but if I say return one, will your program work?
Yes.
So why return 0? Why you make a conversion? Are you getting my, what is my question is, there is an int, instead of return 0, you can make, as well as make return 1, return 2.
If, is the standard.
Yes, why standard? Yes, good, you are nailed in the, you are just hit on the nail. Why 0?
There is standard for success.
Yes, that's correct. First of all, C doesn't have any error handling capacity. What Java has. Java, you don't have to write return 0. Because Java knows anything other than, say, if you array out of index, then you should point, you should, it is your responsibility, the C programmer, to write return 1 or return 2. If there is an error, that is a C programmer's duty to return with a different, other than 0. So that the program outside, the OS or any other program which using that function, because you can see main. The main can call functions, functions can call functions. But that is the convention that whenever functions return in a correct way, you should return it with 0. And if the functions say is array is 0 to 100, so if it is catches 101, then array, because C doesn't handle dynamic array, so it will give an error, then it should return with return 1 or return 2. That is purely as a convention for the C programmer. So in C program, there are various kinds of error. What kind of errors you can foresee? One error, definitely your you are making a float to an int. That is a typecasting error. Okay, because if it is a int to float, it is always done. Because all, but sometimes you are reverse casting, or maybe the array out of index. Your array is one, you are accessing another. Yes. So there you cannot return with return 0. So there should be a different return type. And that is the conventions the programmer should agree that I will use integer 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, so that debugging will be easier. Because any C program cannot be learned by one C program. Is it 2-3 programmers, 10 programmers? But you probably learn any operating system, say your Windows 10, it is basically written in C, and maybe 1,000 programmers have written, and another 10,000 have written earlier. So how to handle? So there should be some conventions in each big companies. So different types of error condition should be numerically enumerated. What is enumerated? That you should give a 0 for correct and any other thing, ones and different kinds of error. So that is the reason you should always choose int main for all your practice. Are you getting my point? Why not void main? Void main will do the purpose. That is a stupid thing. Because at this age, you cannot do all this stupidity. Float. This is, nobody use float. You can, your program will run. But what will return the float? But the operating system doesn't know what to do with 1.22. Okay, that is one thing I should mention. And another thing, whenever Devan sir has told that is a.exe, in Unix, it should be a.out. Okay, and another thing, you should try to also practice that any file, GCC or CC. So if your first program is first one dot C, you should explicitly name your object file name. How to explicitly name your object file name? Anyone? I think you know. You should not want that your program output should be a dot out. Then what should be your choice? You program name, you should have option. What is the option? No. That is an option minus O. And there you can say first or anything dot out. Are you getting it right? Or it may be not out, it may be dot O. So Unix doesn't demand that your executable file should have extension exe or com. Unix doesn't do it. Whether that is the executable permission or not. So if you don't want that your file should not be named, default is a.out. But whenever you run a different all types of programs, your earlier program a.out will be superimposed. So it is better to have minus O option. Are you getting my point? Any doubt? Yes. So another thumbs rule for choosing your good books is that program should be have int main. There should not be include conio.h. That is you just search it. If it's a good book or not, certain books your books appears to be good. Like I should not name one, Mr. Venugopal's book is appears to be good, but I don't recommend that book because all examples in Turbo C. There is no point to unlearn all these things. You have a precious time. Then you don't have enough time. You learn Turbo C, then you unlearn Turbo C. So any book which includes conio.h, you should not read this book. Okay? Conio is console.io.h. It is the typical header file for Turbo C. So all go for Linux. I recommend that you always should have Carnegie Ritchie's books. That I have told you in another batch. Carnegie Ritchie, Dennis Ritchie, who has invented C book, and we also occasionally see Carnegie. This is the ultimate book on C. Whether right now on that book you should follow. And another Harvard Shield book is also I found very good. Robert Lafford book is good. Tannenbaum book is good. You should go follow the international standard books. Any other questions? So, and this floating double. These are, you should know ANSI standards also. I expect a question one or two. No question, Avantika question. You have any questions? Any issues? Clear?
Yeah. GCC first.
GCC, yes. This is two compilers are there. One is CC. That is the, what is the CC? What is the full name of CC? What is the full name of CC? CC, full name? C compiler. C compiler. What is GCC? There is a one foundation called GNU or something. It is an open foundation, sort of open. So that open means, what do you mean by open software? What do you mean by open software?
Royalty free
and? Yes, you are correct. Here I have to use one Bengali word. That is, I think that is the most appropriate word. It is a mukto. Mukto doesn't mean free. Mukto means it is free from bondage. So whenever you are developing certain software, that is no bondage. You don't have to pay not only royalty, but you also should contribute to that. So that is the GNU Foundation, they have developed all these things. So we personally recommend you use the GCC. It's much more functional than CC. Okay, it is still evolving. You can also contribute to that. Okay. Any other issues, you can ask the question, but whatever I have seen, your preparedness is very poor, I must declare. That is unfortunate. I have taken one of few classes in your last semester. Am I correct? I have taken classes? See, I have told you to do the C at your vacation, but you have not done. Most of you have not done. But we have a weekend coming up. So, next classes we will start. Already pointer has already started. Can you tell me where the pointer started? It's already started. In your practice?
Sir, ampersand.
Yeah, ampersand. It is only the C is the, you can say, most stupidest language.